We'll split the cane in the usual way to the usual width that you would make for your particular chanter. And we'll gouge it in the usual way. And then we'll sand the slip to the desired width in the usual way. Then we're going to finish the gouged surface by sanding to a sanding cylinder. And we'll finish off the interior surface with nice fine sandpaper for a very smooth finish. I cut tapered ends onto the slip, and I like to have it leaving about 2 inches of straight material in the slip. We're going to cut that in half, and this will be the top of the blades. I then round off the sharp corners, sanding a couple of times, 2-3 times, on a coarse sandpaper for all 4 of them. And that leaves a more gradual taper. It gradually expands out into the full width of the blade. The reason for doing that is in a finished reed, you'll see right down here where the tails come up and the binding stops, there it flares wider over the lower half of the blade, and that is very convenient for putting a metal or a wire bridle around here to adjust it. If you pull the bridle up where it hits the edges as they get wider, it'll open the reed to stronger strength. If you push it down, it goes into the material that's getting thicker here, and that'll tend to close the blades together for a weaker strength. I've trimmed off the tails to be for the binding of the reed. Mark the center line. I'm going to cut the blades out of the slip. I'll start with a little saw cut to get through the hard part of the bark. And finish with the razor blade. And I bound them together, and here's my staple tube that I'm going to mount into it. And I'll check my length that I need for my particular chanter, and then I'll go ahead, add a drop of super glue to each side to hold it in place, and then bind up the reed. So now the entire reed, the edges are together all the way along at the head. It's tightly bound, and you can see the lips have a relatively low elevation, a fairly narrow opening. With this method, though, we're going to try to decrease that opening. We want the finished reed to end up almost closed in plain geometry even before we start scraping it, because that way the cane will be in a maximum relaxed state when we scrape it, and it'll vibrate freely, and it'll be mostly finished settling before we ever even make the reed. This reed was too open, so I've got a standard bridle holding it closed together. This reed was tending to close too much, so I've put a different bridle here which squeezes only on the edges, and I'll push that up so that it holds it about where I like. In addition, French cane versus the wild Californian, the French bassoon cane tends to keep closing even after you finish the reed. So we will do better with, if we're using French cane, to go for a little greater opening, higher elevation at the lips. With the wild California, I want to close it down right about to the way we have it for playing, because when you wrap the bindings around the California cane, it tends to open them back up. So I'm going to put these two reeds in this tube of plastic, and I'm going to align it with the exhaust of the hairdryer here, slight angle, and then I'll have this thing wedge it so that it doesn't go rolling away. I've got the hairdryer on a countertop here in the kitchen, and I've got it wedged against three objects that are pretty heavy. And we're going to run this for about 5 minutes on hot, and it'll get about 150 degrees temperature in there. If you put a meat thermometer in it, you can measure that.
Very hot air, and I want to make sure it's not blowing on anything important like food or something that could be spoiled by the heat.
Okay, it's been 5 minutes, and I'm going to check the elevation. I will remove any bridles and see if the reed opens up too much or closes down too much. If it's not quite what I want, I can go in for another few minutes. If it's right, we'll just let it cool off, and then we can begin working on the reed once it's cool. Okay, I've done my rough scraping of the reed. I've just cut it down a little bit with a razor blade, and you can see the lips are pretty thick still. And I'll take a quick sand on some sandpaper to smooth that up, and then we'll take our first listen to the reed. Okay, I have quickly sanded the reed, and if we look at the end, you can see that it's opened up very slightly. Let me put that directly straight on and see if the camera will focus on it. It's opened up a little wider than we like for playing. I'm going to put the bridle on it and we'll take a first listen. If you notice, if you can see the end clearly there, it's still a little bit thick compared to what you normally expect for reeds. And we leave them a little thick at this stage because we may need to adjust the inside surface depending on how smoothly the cane formed up. Okay, I've got the reed bridled, and I've got it wrapped on the bottom with thread, and you can see I've got it set down to playing elevation at this point, almost closed. I'm going to inhale through the bass, and we'll see what it sounds like. That's a pretty conventional sound for a concert D reed, so I'll stick it in the head of my Chanter, and we'll just give it a first quick blow. That's a very good sound for a freshly scraped reed. It's a little bit hard to blow, just a little bit, because of the thick cane. It's just very slightly soft in the tone, and that's going to be because there's some microscopic warping on the inside of the blades. I'm going to let this reed sit for a day and just let it settle in its new condition, and we'll return and examine the inside and show how to get a little more brightness out of the sound. Now, if the reed without a bridle is too open or too closed once it's been scraped a little bit, you can always run it through the heat process a second or third time. Set the elevation where you want it using the bridle. If the sides open up, wrap a little bit of thread around the sides to hold them together, and then pop it back in the heat, and it'll be just fine for another 5 minutes. 5 minutes is probably fine. Alright, it's been 5 minutes. Now, when the reed's fresh out of the heat, you can take a card or a razor blade and insert in the top and see how tight the edges are. these edges are pretty loose. But if the edges are very tightly gripped together, it's going to create a problem in the tone and response of the reed. So while the reed cools, you can have that inserted and just let it rest for the 5 or 10 minutes while it cools off, and that'll help relax some of the excess tension there at the edge. And then you can go ahead and test for tone. If you like the tone, you're done, and you have a reed same day. It probably takes less than an hour to make a reed from scratch using the heat method. And it's not only ready to play, but because of the heat, it's been settled down, and it should be dependable from the opening moment. If there are problems with the tone, it requires the interior surface to be re-smoothed on a curved cylinder, which is discussed in another video, and I'll leave the link here.